Here we are, once again, building community in a changing climate with the Interfaith Devotional and Climate Conversation. And it's sponsored by the Interfaith Climate Group, and we're providing a spiritual foundation for the Climate Collaboratory, a multicultural project of We the World and a growing network of partners. Hello, it's me, the sage in Grandma Sue Blythe, and I have a story to tell my grandchildren so they can tell their grandchildren. I call our story On the Road to 2030, 2050, and Beyond. Our story starts in the year 2050, when the Earth's temperature is coming back down. In 2050, the sage in me is age 103. My great-grandson Leif has questions, and I have a lifetime of stories to tell. Great-grandma Sage, tell me about the gardens of global unity, where all things are possible. Ah, yes, I remember it well. When I was a young mother, I knew I wanted to tend the garden of love and unity.
At the gate of the garden, some stand and look within, but do not care to enter. Others step inside, beholding the beauty, but never penetrate far. Still others encircle this garden, inhaling the fragrance of the flowers, having enjoyed their full beauty, pass out again by the same gate. But there are always some who enter, and when they behold, they remain for life. They remain for to tend the garden. Still others encircle this garden, inhaling the fragrance of the flowers, having enjoyed their full beauty, pass out again by the same gate. But there are always some who enter, tend the garden.
In 2018, I found myself in We the World's 11 Days of Global Unity, from September 11th to the International Day of Peace on September 21st. Each day had a theme, and we talked with people who were making a difference in that area. I began to dream of what we could do in 11 gardens of global unity. We could grow seed ideas from vision to reality.
Been a long time running. I never knew then what I know now. That the fruits, they always come in, but you can't go around just knocking them down. It takes a long time to show in. We plant the seeds then and we look at them now. But the roots are always growing, no matter if I'm there or never around. Whatever grows will grow, whatever dies will die, whatever works will work, whatever flies will fly, whatever fails will fail, what's meant to soar will soar. I am planting seeds, nothing.
It's like
more.
Your whole life you've been training for this moment, and when the time comes, you just disown it, meaning you just surrender, don't control it. Not interested in the clay pots and molding, or sitting next to the path trying to unfold it, or waiting for the fruits to fall down toward you. Let it go and now you're flowing, feeling quite gorgeous, so you take steps away instead of towards it. What a rush, feeling freedom with nothing to hold. We've been taught that what you touch will always turn to gold, and now we're learning when we let it go, it overflows with no credit to take, cause no credit is home. A higher power working deeper with the seeds are sowed, and when the seeds are true, then they're seeds of gold. But the real gold is joy when life starts to flow, and when it does, you just smile, cause now you know.
I spent a long time running, I never knew then what I know now. Let the fruits, they always come in, but you can't go around just knocking them down. It takes a long time to show in, we plant the seeds then, and we look at them now. But the roots are always growing, no matter if I'm there or never around.
Whatever grows will grow, whatever dies will die, whatever works will work, whatever flies will fly,
whatever fails will fail, what's meant to soar will soar. I am planting seeds,
whatever grows.
Yep, when it grows, it grows.
Whatever dies, will
and when it dies, it dies.
Whatever
come on.
Works, work.
If it works, it works.
Whatever flies, will
let it fly, let it
whatever
fly.
Whatever fails, will fail.
When it fails, it
what's
fails.
What's meant to soar, will
and
soar.
When it soars, it soars.
I am planting seeds.
Whatever grows, will grow.
Let it grow, let it grow.
Whatever dies, will die.
If it dies, it
whatever
dies.
Whatever works, will
grow. When it works, it
whatever
works.
Flies,
yeah.
Will fly.
Let it fly, let it
whatever
fly.
Whatever fails, will fail.
If it fails, it fails.
What's meant to soar.
And nothing more.
The sages of the ages would bring words of wisdom from the world's spiritual and cultural traditions to nurture those seed ideas.
Oh God, we are as plants, and thy bounty is as the rain. Refresh and cause these plants to grow through thy bestowal. Every bestowal emanates from thee. Every benediction is thine. Thou art mighty, thou art powerful. Thou art the giver, and thou art the ever bounteous. From Baha'i Faith, Abdu'l-Bahá.
The earth does not belong to man. Man belongs to the earth. All things are connected like the blood that unites us all. Man did not weave the web of life. He is merely a strand in it. Whatever he does to the web, he does to himself. Chief Seattle.
Finally, brothers and sisters, rejoice. Strive for full restoration. Encourage one another. Be of one mind. Live in peace. And the God of love and peace will be with you. Christianity, Corinthians.
Provide all, especially children and youth, with educational opportunities that empower them to contribute actively to sustainable development. Earth Charter.
Welcome to the Gardens of Global Unity. Follow us to the 11 Gardens.
So we went into the Gardens of Global Unity. We found them at the Kanapaha Botanical Gardens right here in Alachua County. And the Alvarez children that you just saw made a whole family of little gnomes to take us on a tour. We had different tour guides for different ages. The children's story was a kind of fairy tale.
Pasha, today I'm going to show you the whole garden of fairies, mermaids, and gnomes. Okay, over here is Pinky Gnome, and she loves doing parties, but in type of, you know, plants. Okay, over here is Super Gnome, and Super Gnome loves saving plants. Over here is Girly Gnome, and she loves taking walks everywhere and loves the nature.
So that garden really came to life in their backyard. Well, in the Gardens of Global Unity, young people had everything they need to grow seed ideas from vision to reality.
Ladies and gentlemen, with us tonight is one of the good guys of contemporary music, Mr. John Denver.
Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless these seeds I sow. Someone warm them from below till the rain comes tumbling down. Pulling weeds and picking stones, man is made of dreams and bones. Feel the need to grow my own, 'cause the time is close at hand. Grain for grain, sun and rain, find my way in nature's chain. Tune my body and my brain to the music of the land.
Inch by inch, row by row,
temper them with prayer and song. Mother Earth will make you strong if you give her love and care.
Love and care.
Old bro watching hungrily from his perch in yonder tree. In my garden I'm as free as that feathered thief.
Inch by inch, row by row.
Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground.
Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless these seeds I sow. Someone warm them from below till the rain comes tumbling down.
Till the rain comes tumbling down.
Inch by inch, row by row.
Miracle is almost another word for religion. For once one witnesses a miracle, the worship of God follows effortlessly. Hinduism today.
There can be no doubt whatever that the peoples of the world, of whatever race or religion, derive their inspiration from one heavenly source and are subjects of one God, Baha'i faith.
The Lord our God is one Lord, Judaism.
He is God alone, God the Eternal, and there is none like unto him, Islam, Quran.
With God, all things are possible. Christian, Matthew, 1926.
We watch for all kinds.
I'll take this one. We watch for all kinds of magic in the gardens of global unity, where all things are possible.
Salagadoola, menchikaboola, bibbidi-bobbidi-boo. Put them together, and what have you got? Bibbidi-bobbidi-boo. Salagadoola, menchikaboola, bibbidi-bobbidi-boo. It'll do magic, believe it or not. Bibbidi-bobbidi-boo. Now salagadoola means a menchikaboola-roo. But the thingamabob that does the job is bibbidi-bobbidi-boo.
Oh, salagadoola, menchikaboola, bibbidi-bobbidi-boo.
We ask people to think about the kind of magic or miracles they hope to see by the year 2030 when we win the global goals. In the Gardens of Global Unity, Pacha and Paco collected videos of young people growing their own seed ideas. Sorry.
We declare you graduated as Green Ambassadors.
The thing about the Green Ambassadors, which is so powerful to me and I love it, is because we get to do the solution. It's not the teacher doing it. It's actually youth empowering youth because we're in charge of it.
In our Green Ambassadors class, we work on projects that can help our school first, and then we can go out in the community to teach others about it. And of course, that all goes back to our ecological footprint and climate change.
Here in the United States, we're trying to change it, and many countries don't see that. They just think that we're bad, we're the big monster that wants to destroy the planet. Most of our energy comes from fossil fuels, like oil, natural gas, and coal. Once you burn them, they emit CO2. And the greenhouse gases are like laying a blanket on our planet, and it's heating it up.
Our school is going through a green transformation.
Our school, we had a lunch system that would create so much waste. So last semester, we worked on a project called Clean Plate Club.
These are our waste stations. We have compost, fruits, vegetables, eggshells. We have recycled, so plastic bottles only, numbers 1 and 2. And we have landfill. And we want to raise awareness, and we also want people to see what can go in the landfill. Right here is our number one method of compost. We're using an old bathtub to put our organic matter from the waste bins. Worms are breaking it down to compost. We're gonna get good, healthy soil for our plants, our fruit trees. We planted 60 different fruit trees with over 30 varieties. Trees get the carbon dioxide out of the air, so planting more trees can reduce your carbon footprint. The coolest thing for me was that we actually got to plant the trees, so we can go back 20 years later and say, hey, I planted that avocado tree, I planted that kiwi tree. And we also went into the community door to door asking people, do you want a kiwi tree? Do you want an avocado tree? We planted 40 different trees in the community. That's the most important thing, to educate people, because they don't know. I don't like when we judge other people instead of teaching them.
One way that our school has taken our learnings and teachings out to the rest of the community, to the rest of the city. We teach little kids about what they can do and take back to their homes, to their schools, to make their school environmentally friendly. They're trying to reduce the plastic by getting the canteens, and so that they don't have to be buying plastic bottles.
We're at the Environmental Youth Conference, and I'm dressed as a plastic bag monster. Everyone is walking up to me, taking pictures and laughing. But this is a serious problem. Climate change is hitting us. I mean, we need solar panels. We need wind energy. We don't need to be going offshore drilling for oil. There are the solutions, but we need to use them. You'd really be surprised what one Earth Positive solution can do to a community. We're doing all of this for the seventh generation, for my sister's kids and her kids, kids, kids.
We can do the simplest things to make this world a better place.
I can learn how to care about the Earth. You can too.
You can make a difference.
Pata and Paco also collected videos of adults who were growing seed ideas in their homes, schools, and communities.
Friend the after-school program, the children count about 15 children each afternoon, Monday through Thursday, and Miss Geneva has wonderful snacks for them.
So it's hard to hear, but what she did was a after-school program that I participated in as well, and we read the story of Pacha and used it to start a whole unit where they explored all the trees in the whole complex there, and then planted three new ones with the help of the city arborist, who was giving away free trees to anyone who would plant to or commit to water them for 6 months. And we found the people who would do that, and the kids were so proud of themselves. And the elders collected tools and resources for all ages and wanted to get them to the right people at the right time. So these are some tools that we have for action planning in youth programs. These are all for young people. And the Global Collab is using the Sustainable Development Goals to focus the work of the young people. Peace First helps young people to identify an injustice in their own community and make an action plan to address that. And the Ambition Accelerator is for people who have started their ideas and have a program that they would like to scale up. And so all of these are wonderful resources for young people. We used the Global Goals Treasure Hunt to organize all those seed ideas and stories of what people were doing for a sustainable, just, and peaceful future. And in fall 2024, we had a powerful team to help with the win the Global Goals by 2030. So this is the International Climate Action Challenge that'll take place from September through November. And I've been involved with it for 3 years, and I think we have a magnificent team to work on it this year. So I'm excited about that. We had everything we needed to tell the next chapter in the story of life on Earth. And the rest is history, said Leaf. Thanks, Great-Grandma Sage. That's what we need for the holographic Tree of Life for the 50th anniversary of the Earth Charter. You know, I said, we knew we were making history by helping to grow the seed idea planted way back at the turn of the 21st century.
Let ours be a time remembered for the awakening of a new reverence for life, the firm resolve to achieve sustainability, the quickening of the struggle for justice and peace, and the joyful celebration of life, Earth Charter.
And we asked people what seed ideas they would like to grow in the gardens of global unity, where all things are possible.